welcome to the Jazz Ride Home. Thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you very much. I'm glad that you could be here today.
You are fresh off an airplane.
I am. Exactly.
I love that. But I want to, first of all, let's get a little background from you.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
How many documentary films have you done?
Well, I've worked at CBS for the last 20 years, and I worked on 9/11. I did some music films. I did a film on Machito, the Afro-Cuban, and I did a baseball movie right before this. And suddenly, I became interested in Bill because his music just took me by storm. It was a lot of the things everybody digs Bill Evans, I really loved. And I started to look into his life, and I realized there's more to this guy than I thought. And I started to actually poke around and started to do some interviews with people. And a lot of the people that I talked to are still around, and they were more than willing to talk about Bill. Is even willing to talk about it because a lot of time has passed since he passed.
Mm-hmm.
And I got some really interesting things, particularly like by Paul Modian. He was the guy that really sort of opened me up to really do this interview. I did an interview with him at the Village Vanguard, and he was really honest and he was really direct, and he really loved Bill. I could feel he really loved Bill, and he really loved Scott LaFaro, and that just kicked me into wanting to do it. It just happened that day. I walked out of the interview and said, well, I have to do this. I'm going to track down everybody that will talk to me about Bill, and do the interview about Bill Evans. And that started my 8-year journey to make this film. And it's been a long time.
Did you first approach Paul Modian because you wanted to do this film of Bill Evans, or were you kind of feeling things out? How did that first meeting happen?
Well, it was crazy. I thought, well, he's the man. He was the drummer in the great trio of Sundays in the Vanguard and Waltz for Debbie. I thought, he's around. I'm going to talk to him. And I talked to one other. I talked to Chuck Israels first, and he was very good as an interview. But he was, you know, he was staid, and he had a lot of interesting things to say. But Paul was a live wire, and just something happened. At first, I didn't know that I was going to make the film. I didn't really know I was going to make the film. I just thought, well, I'll just poke around and see who will talk to me. And that interview, something magically happened in that interview that... It was just a moment of truth where I said, well, I have to do this because of this guy. And of course, Paul is no longer with us.
Mm-hmm.
A lot, like a lot of people in the film, a lot of people that I interviewed are no longer with us. And that's how it happened. People like Gene Lees, people like Jim Hall, people like Bobby Brookmeyer, people like Billy Taylor, they're all in the fame. It has some really interesting things to say, along with Harry's wife, Pat Evans, who's in the film, who's recently passed away. So this was finding something important that I wanted to do. And it was all because of really Paul and what he said about Bill and his love for the music and his love for Bill and his love for Scott LaFaro. So Scott LaFaro plays a big part in the film. As a bass player, so
that passion and affection was infectious to you, but I'd like you to talk a little bit about Bill's music for you, because you said something in an earlier interview that I read,
right,
that I think is really very telling about the music of Bill Evans. When I've talked with other people, and it applies to myself as well,
right.
You heard Bill Evans' music, but then when you got older, you understood what you were hearing.
Well, I'm going to tell you something, like Kind of Blue, just for an example, like Kind of, you listen to Kind of Blue. The first Blue, I fell in love with the piano playing of Whitten Kelly. Mm-hmm. I thought it was hip, it was cool, it was funky. I just related to that. But the older I got, you know, I guess you mellow, things change. I really guess it was Everybody Digs Bill Evans, Peace Peace, and a couple of tunes on that. The tune that I really liked is a solo he does, Lucky to Be Me. It's a solo piano piece on that. And I thought, Jesus, it's just staggeringly beautiful. It just takes you to a place that you normally wouldn't go to. And very rarely do you find a piece of music that hits you like that. And when that piece of music hit me, I thought, well, I have to find out more about Bill. I gotta do some more about Bill. And it was kind of funny. Little tunes, Polka Dots and Moonbeams off of the Moonbeams album. The way it starts, I heard that tune 50 different times by 100 different players, but nobody does that tune the way it sets up the introduction to the tune. It's the way he voiced the chords, is the feeling and expression that he brought to the music. It just strikes a heart, it strikes you in the heart, and it just got me to thinking about this guy's music and all that he brought to the music, and I just wanted to find out as much as I could about this guy, because he's not an easy guy to understand. Bill Evans was not an easy guy. He kept to himself. He was introverted. I think the things with the drugs kept a lot of people off. So he wasn't he wasn't an easy guy to understand. Mm-hmm. And it became almost a detective work, talking to people about, like, who is this guy? Mm-hmm. What did you find out? What were the things in this guy? And it was like the detective part of me the more. And that's why I just went to the bottom of it and found and talked to as many people that could deal with me to talk about Bill Evans. I talked to everybody that would talk to me. And, you know, that's how it was. You're a man on a mission, really, when there's something like this. So.